I think we're live. I'm going to pretend like we're live anyway. I'm doing something a little different today. I thought, well, we don't need that hanging in the middle of it for one thing. What I'm trying to do here is a master study of a John Singer Sargent. The thing is, I'm doing it in acrylics and it's not high dollar acrylics. What I'm using also is some propylene glycol, which is a retardant. I've had this for a long time, so I chose to use this. Essentially, this is like antifreeze. So you don't want to get this in the hands of anyone who doesn't know how to handle it. You want to make sure that you keep it safe. Take necessary precautions. I've put just a very small amount in this container. And then I've mixed it with some of my acrylics on this plate. And we're going to see what we can do. I've also got the same image that's on your screen. I've got it a hard copy here. And you can see the color is a little different between this and the image that you, which is to be expected. Printing and monitors and all that can make a difference. And I'm trying to somewhat follow the same method, even though I'm using acrylics. I'm going to try to do similar with this. What this is vine charcoal. And I'm just kind of blocking it out. And then I got it wet to create blocks of tone. Size-wise, this is not the same. Mine's a little bit closer, obviously, on just the head study. Try to center it up there a little bit. The colors that Sargent would have used are titanium white. I believe he would have used a lead, but of course we're not going to do that because of safety. But we'll use antifreeze. By the way, I got this, if you're curious about this stuff, I got this through a pharmacy. And it is controlled, you have to sign for it, and I got this maybe 15, 20 years ago, so the laws may have changed, and it will depend on where you live at. So, just a heads up. I got this when I was in graduate school to experiment with. And Sargent has a very loose, painterly looking aspect to his work. So that was one reason I chose to try that. I mean, I could just make it simpler and use oils, but what's the fun in that? So what I'm doing is I'm just adding water to this, kind of blocking it out. What'll happen is this vine charcoal will bond in the acrylic and they will become one. This might be a complete failure or it might be something really cool. We'll just have to see. I guess we will soon find out. I'm doing this in my sketchbook that I tend to do all of the lives in here lately. And it's on a Bristol board or Bristol paper. Kind of trying to pull that out a little bit because it's got a highlight there. Highlight there. And this paintbrush is just inexpensive. I believe I can't even see the name on it. I've had it for so long. I started to say he used titanium white, raw sienna, vermilion red, rose madder, raw umber, ivory black, ultramarine blue, and chromium green. He also tended to use mineral spirits. The article that I got this information from, was Artists and Illustrators out of the UK. It was an article that they had by, I believe it's Lizette Dingerman. So if this works, we need to give her credit because this article came out and had his supplies in, although she has him using his traditional materials of oils, of course. And then his nose doesn't come quite like that, does it? And then he also, in the article, she did not use her. She used a material that was called Sansodor, sans odor, I believe might be what it's called, which is a type of odorless mineral spirits. It's low odor and it evaporates really fast. Me see how we're doing on proportions. Yeah, I need to this up there. It's a little lighter there, a little lighter there. What it is, it's much easier to fix errors in proportion and perspective and all that good stuff. It's much, much easier to correct it when you're blocking everything in than it is once you've got some paint down. Let's see, this is, let me get some tissue here. It's just cheap paper towel is all this is. Water some of that out. In here and blot it off. That looks better to me anyway. This paper has been gessoed. I gessoed it with a transparent gesso, which I like because it has a texture to it. There's a little bit of a tooth that wouldn't be there. I'm just kind of erasing that hard line I put there. So what I'm doing at this level is just blocking in the values and which is what he would have done. He also would have used vine charcoal or willow charcoal to mark things. Let's see, what did I do with my vine charcoal? No, I have it here. Oop, there it is. Oh, there's some anyway. A little further out. And this comes down more. More like that. I do not have the equivalent of his colors in acrylic. So, like I said, I'm using very inexpensive ones. So this could be a complete waste of time, and I may ruin it, or I may discover what I have is just fine for right now. When I use oils, I tend to use professional grade. But I am trying to use up materials that I've already got in the studio rather than buy new. Just out of practicality and to I'm definitely not a minimalist, but I have a lot of supplies I need to use up. I have more supplies than I will probably use in my lifetime. So, I think that's common among creatives. Come across something, especially if it's on sale, you'll purchase it and then figure out how to use it later. You'll notice I'm not drawing in details of the eyes or any other areas. I'm merely blocking things in. You don't want to put the eyes in until you're for sure where the eye socket is supposed to go. And I'm continually looking at the screen to see proportions and I really like this shadow he has right in here. It's kind of, I don't know, it's like a mid-tone. You can hear the scratchiness. Let me scoot this up just a little. You can hear the scratchiness of the gesso I've laid on here. The painting itself, I have not studied a great deal. I did look to see if it was a water, or not a watercolor. I looked to see if it was a pastel because of some of the marks that he's got on here. But apparently it's not. It is an oil. You see this like bloom up here? We can kind of, it'll get painted over, but let's make that go away. I just realized that was not Bloom. That was the top of his little hat, wasn't it? That's okay. Whatever. I'm not sure what that is. If it's a hat or a something else. We've got that on there. Let's see. We've got people in the chat, which is always a good thing. Hello. If anybody has any questions, just holler. I didn't feel like being on camera today. I'm kind of ugh. So, usually I'm on camera too, but I opted out of it this time. Let me see if I can fix this a little bit. Didn't want you to do that. There we go. There we go. That's better. At least for my... from my viewpoint. Okay, let's go ahead and I can just let this dry at this point, or I can just keep on. I want to get this edge of his ear here. That looks wonky. No offense, but I think I gave him a Stephen Colbert ear. No offense to Stephen Colbert. Sure, I got the proportions there right. There's a delay in the recording, and what's happening. I'm not really sure why it's so prevalent this time, but I didn't change any settings or let's get that up there. That's a little better. Looks like he's kind of winking at us, doesn't it? Another thing you want to be, those of you that came in late, I'm using propylene glycol, and so it's, you want to make sure and use precautions if you go that route. It is poisonous. If any of the any animals drink it, cats liking to drink antifreeze. If you spill it on your driveway, I don't know if y'all remember that being a issue. If all of you are old enough to or not, but. Back when you could do your oil changes and all in your driveway. I don't think this looks looks like he has a black eye, didn't it? Anyway, this is just the blocking in. This is just charcoal. you just keep playing around with this and moving it around until you get your values how you want them. I don't know. This area, I wonder if his ear should be back more. Oh, now he's got a Vincent Van Gogh ear, huh? Come on, baby. There we go, that's a little better. But I won't get this exactly right. We're just, like I said, we're blocking it in. Just so we know where we need to put certain aspects. I've got notes here I'm looking at, so from the article I mentioned earlier. Oh no, I think my paintbrush just broke. Look at that. Did it? Maybe not. Then once he would do this, he would block it in with a raw sienna. So it would help seal this vine charcoal. Into the paint once it's applied. I am not going to use raw sienna. I am going to use a I believe it's burnt umber and a little bit of black with a lot of water. That will just get this background in here. Hopefully that propylene glycol will slow down the drying time and it will help us get a little bit more workable paint time. Yeah, you know what I'm saying. We don't want that right there. Got a little bit too much water on there, didn't I? But we go over this and check it, make sure everything's where we want it. I've got a container of water here. Also, these little containers, I found these have come in really handy. I got these at the Dollar Tree. There's like 10 of them for $1.25, which have been worth their weight in gold for me. They are amazing. They're just the right size. Another thing, he would paint this all in one day. If he couldn't get it the way that he wanted it, by the end of the day, he would smear it and make it all blurred, which I didn't know he did that, because, and I've been doing that on some some recent things. Fairly recent, I should say. At this point, it almost resembles more like a watercolor. Let me see if that paint there is still. Yep, it's still workable, which is a good sign. Maybe propylene glycol is helping. I've got a spray bottle here too. I don't like that I'm holding my brush this way. I'm getting tight. I know this background is more like a shows up on the monitor more like a kind of an army green. So we'll work toward that once we get our thicker paint on there. I'm still not focused on getting the details at all. I'm getting the shapes and the values. And if at any time you lose what you working on, you can always get it right back. It's just paint. I found this gesso really absorbent, so I should have no problem going over this with the actual paint. I did not add black to that. I should have. I can't really see this tie area that well. There is some warping to this paper happening too. But that's okay. It will work itself out in the end. And if I find this paint is drying too fast, I can always add more of the propylene glycol and get it and you'll notice I'm not doing like an outline on the background to foreground. It's not all clear cut. But it's obvious where it is. I know this area is too dark. Once he got the background kind of painted in, I don't feel like I have it correct, so I am going to mix me some nice juicy paint here. I can start putting that, some of that in. I know that's a little bright. Dull it down here. Now he scrumbled in the, which just means like a dry brush, kind of, just like that. It wouldn't be nice, juicy strokes, so I need to do it that way if I'm gonna get that down. There's enough delay in it that right now I am not seeing how it looks on the monitor. The background, that is, with the color added. Usually you can combine an ultramarine blue and some burnt umber, and it will give you a really nice gray color. And this brand of paints that I'm using, which I said is just really inexpensive stuff, is not allowing me to do that. I hope it's showing up for you, because it's not showing up for me. It looks almost neon yellow or neon green in my camera monitor. No, that's not the color. So let's try and neutralize it down a little bit. That's better. For me, sorry, I just had a flash of, for me, I like corn. That's a little better. And then we want to get in the main color of his coat, and And I'm not trying to get the paint real thick on here and textured like. I'm just trying to block in the And I don't know how it looks at your end, but I am frozen. I'm going to hope this is recording and just keep on, keep on. Then what we want to do is paint the midtones. And we get a nice kind of I'm not sure what to call it, honestly. A Caucasian wind in this case. There we go, that's good. Gotta We just do this thickly, it says. That looks too peachy. And too dark. And that's thick, all right. Looks very purple to me. I would text somebody or message somebody that was in chat, but unfortunately, the device I would use to do that is what I'm trying to film with. You want to keep your brush nice and clean at this point, too. You don't want to bring in colors that you don't want. And I'm trying to keep this still nice and thick, if at all possible. I don't like what this brand does on it's, I have to mix certain colors. It just doesn't. I think I may have just lost connection. I sure did. There it goes. And this brush is not adequate at this point. I've used it for the charcoal and the I'll change to a flat. Fine, you can get a lot of these areas. And I'm not sparing anything on the paint. I am putting it on very liberally. Sienna. I'm trying to see if I have a better. My brown and my ultramarine blue are not cooperating. Maybe add a touch of black. Sorry, I know you can't see this, but is starting to get a little dry, a little gummy on the surface. That we don't want. We want it to stay nice and thick. Like I said, he would have done this in oils, and this might be a complete failure to try to do this way. But we shall see what happens. Trying to make this look a little yellower. He has more of a blonde highlight in his beard and whatnot. Spritzed it there. See if that helps keep it juicy at all. I don't think it is. And some nice juicy paint in there to get that part right there back. There we go. Where's my juicy paint? I am not very satisfied with how this is going. It's just not. I think I would have had a lot better results had I used oils. But I am going to keep on, keep on. I would assume that this is where he would have used the rose madder in much of the area around his nose and eye. Don't know at this point if the propylene glycol is making much difference at all. Noticing a lot of his edges are just soft. There's not very many hard edges. I'm going to put some of that juicy color. This is a very pale. I'm not trying to get the white whites in yet because it's too soon. You want those to look really fresh. think I got his ear positioned incorrectly. So we'll fix that. Which might be a good thing, because I didn't get the color very good that first time around. And I know I got this edge wrong, but that's going to be an easy fix. In just a second. He's got a softness kind of in there. There's like a yellow ochre. A light yellow ochre on his hat. I got that part way too high. It's all just kind of pulling forward and going back and manipulating it until you are satisfied. I'm trying to follow a system of some sort. Eyelid right there, his eyebrow in there is much, much lighter than what I've got there. Problem is that my burnt umber, you lighten it and it looks purplish. I do not like my brown. I do not like my brown at all. Am I am? That would have made a great hair color. If I go radio silent, it's because I'm thinking while I'm working. This has a pretty clean edge along there on the whole piece. It's got some lighter areas in there. Yeah, there's a big delay on the monitor. It's coming to, it's taking shape somewhat. Just trying to soften some of these edges a little bit while the paint's still nice and wet. Because it's not lasting long. Probably need to use a lot more propylene glycol, but I'm hesitant to I think it's going to take some testing on my part. It's been too long since I used it. In this form. Knocked down nicely. Kind of a nice gray in here, nice juicy gray. Nice cool gray. And then this in here needs to be knocked down. There we go. That's a lot better. We are getting there, people. It is 6 o'clock on my time. I don't think that's too darn bad. I'm spritzing everything so it'll stay nice and fresh. I'm gonna get me some fresh water here. Excuse my chair squeaking. Fresh rag. We're off to the races again. That's my high-tech water container there. Go ahead and get that eyebrow in there. I got a little water on my iPad. I think it's okay. Oh, I just habitually started using the rag ahead. Let's see. Nice kind of peachy orange in there. We cooking with gas. And I got his beard a little low, or his mustache. So I'll fix that real quick. I think maybe if I just defined this area. Help. Of course, Sargent's mostly known for Madam X. It's probably the one people think of. I am using some white on my palette, on my brush, but I am using it more as a to lighten the tones than I am to create a white area. Let me see, I got that too much. So let me wipe that back off. Let me get this other brush in here. This is it's a Krumbacher 2 round. It's a Degas round. I got it from Rosemary and Co. Long time ago. I like Rosemary and Co. brushes, and they have served me well. That if I were to do it over again, I don't know that I would go for that budget that way. Because there's some really good synthetic brushes that you can buy that are much more easily attainable. I'm trying to get the color of his eyebrow here, so I can just swoop that in there. That is way too dark. Now I've gotten it too light. It has kind of a rosy tone in his shadows. Look like on the monitor. It is drying really quickly. I am going to go ahead and pull out the propylene glycol and start adding some of it with my brush because I don't like how that's that might cause me problems because I'm adding something that dries slower. Well, no, I wouldn't. Never mind what I just said. That's what we want. We don't want fast over. Fat over lean, as many of us are familiar with saying. I'm trying to keep his hairline there, not being just a smooth edge. That's not what we want. Same with down here. We want that. I got that tone pretty well. Value. Harsh. Contaminated my color there. Get a darker tone for that's better. I need to either add more of the propylene glycol to the paint at the very beginning, or use it as a just like a medium. Yellow. did start a new channel today. Don't have anything up over there yet. I mean, it is crickets. I haven't done anything but create it. That's it. That's all I've done. The point of it is going to be just for these art videos. And I don't know that I'm going live next week because I need to get some videos edited and up. That was way too light. That's better. We are getting there slowly but surely. As a Karen to a manager. Anybody know where that saying came in? The whole Karen? Why are Karens the ones that are the name Karen? What's the story there? Why are they Karens? Why aren't they Cindy's or Melissa's? Betty's. Doesn't it sound like a, well, then you got Betty White, though. You know Betty White wouldn't do nothing. Didn't do anything inappropriate. Mean. My brush was contaminated there. Notice the here and there, isn't it? You know, I'm falling back on my own painting things. I'm totally forgetting what he would have done. I'm just continuing to. I don't know that that's a good thing. See, that's completely dry right there. I don't know that I'm going to get this completed today. It has a lot of things that could need more work than what I can do in a 2-hour span. So cool that he did this with such a limited palette. Every time I dip my brush in the water, there's a little drip that I don't catch. That is dried. I wonder what would happen if I painted over this with oils. If it would look a lot better. Does anybody else hear TikTok songs in their head? Like an earworm? No, just me. I think this is going to take more than one time. We've got some progress here. I'm going to go ahead and break the rules and put some white in here. Because I wonder if I didn't get his beard too long. Right in there. White is never white, white. Always other values in there. There's a little pink, there's a little blue, those aren't values, but you know what I mean. Is anybody else just giving up on listening to the news? Because it's just all bad. I hear people doing that, and then I think I have fear of missing out. I have FOMO. I'm just going to keep messing with this and see what we can come up with. Until the top of the hour. But I don't think it's going to be finished. There's just too many things that need attention. It's getting too dry. To do a lot of the forming and a lot of the really loose brush stroke that we like. I think this will make a good underpainting for next time I work on this. It's way too dark. I think we are getting some interesting values. Effects in here. Maybe we wouldn't have. If we had used too dark in here. We had used an oil off the bat. Trying to kind of scrumple that in a little bit to get that. Get that look there. One thing about acrylics is they dry darker than then they go down. think we're doing pretty well on the values and getting the masses down anyway. I don't know what color this is. What color is that? That's way too dark. I started to put down his nostril. But that's just way too dark. The inside of his nostril, that is. Kind of like a half moon shape there. Make some more peachy, fleshy. Side of his nose should be lighter than what I've got there, and on his nostril there. I really don't like how my paint is drying up here. I think next time it would give us a really nice fresh layer. To build off of. It's a nice tone there. So this would sort of be like the underpainting will be the underpainting. It's way too dark. Usually he painted in life size too, so this is much smaller. You can see my hand there. Not that I'm complaining. So I'm having fun. I don't know about you all, but I am having fun. There's nothing better than some good old paint. I would rather do this any day of the week than a lot of things. Get that shadow right there. I know that was a little too dark, so we'll lighten that up some. I'm gonna go ahead and put some wider areas in here. He probably would have waited till it's much closer to being finished. To do, but it helps give us some form here. That fleshy color is just so flat on here. And this white that comes in this paint is not as opaque as I would prefer. Like I said, I'm trying to use up what I have. He looks evil there, doesn't he? It's his eye, that dark eye. That was dark. I'm losing the light on this other side of my right hand side of my work area, and it it's making the color have some issues. No, I got that too. trying to get that mustache underneath his center of his nose. That edge. It should be. Lighter there some areas, but it won't work if I don't have the other. Light in his eye there, because that bugs me. He said it makes him look evil. We don't want evil. He wasn't evil, as far as I know. It's kind of a light bluish green eye there. Kind of a gray. Yeah, I've got it too large too. Knock that back down. Let me get that up. It's not working. It's all right. I'll make it work. So what are you guys doing while I'm doing this? Are you watching or are you working on your own project, or are you doing something else? I personally feel like his eye is still too dark. It looks a little friendlier there. Get the inside of his eye here. His eyebrow isn't out far enough is another reason he looks a little evil there. starting to really tighten up on this, and that's not what we want. It looks like, see that line right through there? His nose should not be out that far. See if we can get that brush is getting kind of worse for wear here. I haven't looked at this with a mirror. Let me get a mirror real quick. Oops. Didn't break it. Getting close. It's not too bad, just needs a lot more work. I'm gonna go ahead and put some of this white in here too, just to kind of freshen it up a little bit. And that kind of comes up and goes around his neck. A little bit of his beard showing there. And then that gray part. And that white is not white. It's actually some leftover, almost white, that I had. But it'll work for underpainting. Get rid of some of those edges on there. I think the bottom of his nose is not up enough, you know what I mean? There's too much space between like here and here. What I'm going to do. paint that out. Excuse me, I'm getting a different brush here. Getting something with a... I don't know that he would have used something this small. I need something this small to push the paint around. I'm thinking of this more and more as an underpainting. I'm just trying to fix some of these issues. I think that helps. Helps in a sense that his nose is more, yeah, that's closer. Yep. I know that's not perfect. I think it's a lot closer to what we're wanting. His eyes. I just gave him jaundice. Maybe it's from all those art supplies. I'm losing my daylight real quickly here and my light is not set up. Is know he looks a little odd right now, but his eye is much more in the right position. And I realize it's after 7. We'll just pretend like it's not, or after 6. 7. 7? Yeah, 7. Let me go ahead and I'm going to fix his eyebrow there some. His eyebrow comes up and then goes out. This appears too too thick. This right in here needs to come down. And I know it looks like his nose, since I repositioned it a little bit, this right here is much. I'm looking in the mirror here to see what we've got. I do believe I am running out of time here. But that's okay. We're not after. Getting it done fast. We want it done right. You know the saying, you can get it done right, fast, or cheap. You can't have all three. You have to choose two of those. I think that's a saying. I keep hearing that, well, I better not sing it because Facebook will frown on that. Not only because of my voice, but because of copyright. I have not taken a break from looking at this since I sat down. So I really need to get a fresh, and then it's just not working there. Fresh outlook on it, fresh viewpoint. Which sometimes the only thing you can do is just step away from it and you come back another day. That was a dirty yellow. I think I am at that point where anything I do is not necessarily going to be helping it. If anybody just got here, I'm like how I just stopped in mid-sentence there. I won't be finishing this today. It's and I know that's too dark. I'm doing it for so I can just see what the heck I'm doing there. Yep, I just need to add some white to that and walk away for now. Because I'm using too fine of a brush for one. I'm getting too tight. If you look at his nose, see how the tip of his nose, the inside of the nostril, it comes out over here. It comes all the way over to there. Come on. All my paint's drying on me. And my daylight's fading. But I just can't stop until I know I have that. Anybody here paints, you know how that is. Or does anything else like that. Let's see, that's I know I went over there too far, but I need to walk away before I just totally. Because it's just drying too fast on me. Figure out where that. And yeah, I know the eye and all is way too light. I'm not at that point. It needs a lot of work, a lot more than I thought it was going to. A lot more than I hoped it would. But that's why we're doing it, right? We're gonna learn from it. Do know the propylene glycol. Could have done without it. I don't think it helped a whole lot in this situation. I need a fresh perspective on this. I know I keep saying that, don't I? And then I could just keep coming back with more paint. Well, that was way too light. I don't know what the neighbors are doing. We started out this wanting to paint the same way that John Singer Sargent did. And I think we have lost that outlook. Just trying to soften that edge some while it's still, even though it's not working very well. Looks like he has a droopy. You see how this is. I need to paint over this and get that shape back. That won't take much. I'm doing this more for my own. Peace of mind at this point, because this comes in here. If I look at the painting itself, it looks like he may have done that as well. As far as coming in, there's kind of a shadow in here on the painting. He painted over. Perhaps. I know I've got that. I think I'll, what I'll do is I'll do a pop-up to finish this, and another day. See, I can't even get a brush stroke out of it. Yeah, I'm just kind of trying to get the placement. Yeah, that's a lot better. I know that needs covered up. Oops. I need to go and wash my brushes. I haven't even been looking at the comments. I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry, folks. I think I'm going to leave it there because I'm going to start darkening foreheads and like this needs to come in. Forehead's too high. We started out with this paint all being nice and juicy. And now it is, I'm nitpicking. And I'm losing a lot of the John Singer Sargent-ish appearance. Something like that needs to go. I guess there's more down here. I think I'm gonna leave it right there. That's a good place to stop. For real, I'm actually like cleaning my brushes off some now. Where's that other one I used? Oh, there it is. I try and get the worst of it off before I set them down. So they're not getting all hard and icky. I'm gonna have to. I really need a fresh eye. This, I think, yeah, there's a lot that needs work. I'm looking at the, like right here, this is too thick. This needs lighter in here. This dark area in there, yeah. But we can do all that much better on a completely dry canvas with fresh eyes. So that's what we're going to try and do. Clean off my palette here. What I do is I just stick it in this. Because a lot of times I'll do things where I can use it again. Rather than waste the... Even though I put glycol in it, I don't think it's going to make that much difference on the... on the paint, as far as mixing with the other. I'm just scooping this up. Does anybody have any questions or anything? Let me look here. I just completely... Halloween Baking Championship. Hey, Jen. I'm so glad you all showed up. Thank you for doing that. I didn't get it complete, but... I think I got a decent start. For a start, I'd probably give it an 8 out of 10. For getting it completely finished, probably about a 1. And see his ear. His ear on the reference photo. It's more... comes out more here. This right... it's... there's more of a angle like this instead of a like this. If that makes sense. I will get that next time. I will. Let me go ahead and finish picking up all my paints and putting things away so I don't have a complete mess and waste supplies. And thank you all for being here. I appreciate you. Oh, thank you, Jen. You're too sweet. It needs a lot of work. It I'm not kidding myself, and it needs it. But we'll do it. I'll do it. It'll happen. So thanks. Thank you all. I'm gonna go ahead and call it a night, and I'll do a pop-up. If anybody wants to see the finished of it, and then you can just watch it at your leisure. So I will see you all later. All right, bye all.